We're here at Mr. Brendan Flaherty's house. There he is over there. And we've got, a couple guys playing on the new table. And literally they know, but we are going to get them to play in a draw. And the winner gets their expenses paid to Kentucky State. So you see, there's Fernando going in the hat. And Trevor. Evan. And Mr. Russ King. And Miss Mary Moore is going to draw the hat. You know what? We'll just have this young lady over here draw names. Just draw names. Don't look at them. What's the first name there?
First name is Russ.
Let me see it. Okay, Russ King is drawing the next name. Whoever the next name is, that's his partner.
That would be Fernando.
All right, there we go.
So Trevor,
guys, we have a team here. It's going to be Fernando Rosa and Russ King against Trevor Park and Evan Stachelek.
How we do?
The stakes here. You know, the winners get their expenses paid to Kentucky State.
Did you hear that, Russ? What's that?
The winners get their expenses paid to Kentucky
State. Airfair in Kentucky.
Yeah, baby.
What do you think, Trevor?
I think it's going to be a fun trip.
There we go. Okay. Fernando, what do you think about the table?
I'll let you know after the tournament.
Is this 3 out of 5?
Evan, do you know what the stakes are?
Yeah, trip to Kentucky.
For those of y'all who don't know this guy, because he's not on tour very often, this is Mr. Evan Stachelek. Tell everybody how long you've been playing.
Very long, about 20 years now.
Too long.
Long time. Too long, says Fernando. Too long.
Well,
we're going to Kentucky. It looks like me and Trevor playing for the first time in a $35,000 tournament in Kentucky. Looking forward to it. Good deal.
What table did you start playing on?
Started playing on a tournament soccer table in 1978, then moved on to the Dynamo Tour in 1982. Then moved on and played some striker tournaments in 1986, I believe, and then tornado tournaments in 1987, all the way through the 90s. And now it looks like we're on to the Warrior Tour.
So you've played on a number of different tables.
You've
been through the transition periods that foosball's gone through. What do you think about going from one different table to another different table?
I think it's really up to the player. The player mentally gets over what they've done throughout the years over and over again. And any good player can adapt and conquer. Look at Todd Lafredo, probably the best player in the world. He's played on every single table I played on. He's still in the top 5 in the world and just won the last tournament. Never bothered him to move from table to table. So it's up to the player to adapt and conquer the situation.
You know, there's a lot of players that kind of have an issue with switching tables.
Every player has an issue with switching tables if they've never switched tables. So all the players that have gone through the transition of different tours and different tables doesn't really have a problem.
They
know how to switch. The players that have a problem are the players that played strictly Garlando or strictly Tornado or strictly Dynamo and never switched onto a different table. Therefore, they're what we call one-dimensional. They can only play in one dimension or on one table at their best.
Do you think this table is comparable in play to a Tornado?
Yes, I do. As far as a Tornado home model, this is a home model cabinet, so it's a little bit lighter than the Tour model, but I think it plays great right now. The man plays great like a Tornado, and we got rid of the flaws on the Tornado man as far as there's a sharp edge now, so you can bank the ball, you can do better chip-up passes on the 5, and everything's a lot more accurate.
Mr. Russ King, by the way, for those of y'all who don't know this man, he is a former world champion. I remember seeing you win the Worlds. Was it 95?
93 is when I actually won the main event. But the bottom line here is not a knock against Tornado, because I've enjoyed my share of success on that table, and it plays wonderful. But there's something new in the wind. I've changed tables many times in my career, and there's a new table, there's a new tour, and there's new worlds to conquer, right? So that's always a good time. And this table, one of the main things it has going for it is the transition period from tornado to warrior is very, very small. So you can take your game and within the space of a day have a competitive game. And I've always found that the best players play good at any table. It doesn't truly matter. We're not tornado players. We're foosball players. And this table plays very, very well. And it's fun to have something new to look forward to. Tornadoes enjoyed a monopoly on the game for a long time. And now that there's something new in the mix, the tours are going to have to compete for the players' attention. And that's always good for the players.
You know, some players just are... They're not going to subscribe to those beliefs, so to speak. What would you say to those people about it?
Anytime that there's a change, people are resistant to change by nature, and that's just a fact. There's always going to be the naysayers. There's going to be people that are actually looking for something to complain about or for something to blame something on. But at the end of the day, the table plays very, very well. If you're a good player, you can play on this table. You can play any table. There's no shortcomings. So that's a big thing. And I think that it's just a matter of the desire of wanting to have a good tour to play on, a good table to play on, and that's what this promises. Tornado is going to have to compete again for the players' attention, and that's good for everybody, right?
Okay, so y'all are going to play a 3 out of 5 match. Who's your partner?
Fernando Rosa.
And so you're playing against Mr. Evan Stachelek and Mr. Trevor Park. How you doing, Trevor?
Good, how you doing?
Miss Vivian Park, how you doing?
Good.
Have you had a chance to play on the table yet?
Get the red ball.
No, but I will.
So far, by just sitting here watching, what do you think about the table?
I think it looks good, and I can't wait for the next tournament, so I'm excited.
So if Trevor wins his... airfare to Kentucky.
I will definitely go too.
That means you get to go, cause.
Yes.
Okay, well, we're gonna wish Trevor good luck. Anyway, guys, so we'll come back to y'all when we got the match going and see who gets to go to Kentucky.
Charge up,
yeah. Let's do it.